In Animate Insanity is a show that's really close to my heart. Despite my content pretty much only covering the FDI, I believe In Animate Insanity is the greatest object show of all time. With the show running for so many years, many mysteries have come with it, which is what this video is about. If you don't know what an iceberg chart is, let me explain. An iceberg chart is an image segmented into multiple layers. The top layer has pretty basic information most In Animate Insanity fans would know. And as we go down the layers, the entries become much more obscure. Instead of taking an iceberg chart from Google, I created my own iceberg, with over 60 entries and a lot of Inanimate Insanity references within it. Remember to like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video, please, it helps me out so much. With that being said, let's move on to the first layer. Adam Katz. Adam Katz is the creator of Inanimate Insanity, as well as being an animator, director, and writer for the show. He's also known for being the voice of Nickel in BFB. Inanimate Insanity Comics. Inanimate Comics is a comic series hosted on the Inanimate Insanity website. The comics mainly focus on the non-competition lives of the Inanimate Insanity cast. I like this series a lot because it gives a lot of light to the more underutilized contestants, the ones who haven't gotten a chance to shine since season 1 or early season 2. Fans Fantastic Features. Fans Fantastic Features is a spin-off of Inanimate Insanity hosted by Fan. It's mostly a variety show where eliminated contestants do game show challenges and interviews. It had 4 episodes featuring Tissues, Trophy, Box, Nickel, Salt, and Pepper, and it's now discontinued. Inanimate Battle. This was another spin-off of Inanimate Insanity. This show was a tournament between real-life Inanimate Insanity objects, where it was basically just Adam bashing 2 objects together to see which one survives. The show actually ran for 4 seasons, and unsurprisingly, Knife was the winner of every single season. This was only because some contestants had to be cut. I doubt Knife would have won against Bomb. Meeple. The Meeple Company is a spoof of the Apple Company. Meeple are responsible for creating the Mephones, Meeped, and other products. The CEO of Meeple is Steve Jobs, Twitter's favorite Inanimate Insanity character, who is based on the CEO of Apple, Steve Jobs. Oh, I get it. Gaming videos. The Inanimate Insanity crew have made multiple videos where they get into character and play random video games. It started with Among Us, and in the recent episodes, they mostly play Jackbox. The condition is the sickness that the character Tissues has, and it's basically just his old personality. The disease is passed by snot, and its symptoms are, I'm not gonna read all that. If you get infected by the condition, you're probably screwed. The only person we ever saw recover from the condition had to get their battery completely replaced, so unless you're planning to get an open heart transplant, you should just stay 6 feet away from Tissues at all costs. Original songs. Inanimate Insanity has a ton of original songs. The ones you probably know are Keep On Cleaning, Afterlife In The Limelight, and my favorite K-pop band song, Aparte. But most of the music you hear in recent season 2 episodes are also original songs made specifically for Inanimate Insanity. Calm Down Areas. The Calm Down Corner is a place in season 2 where contestants go to, well, it's in the name. It has a bunch of random scribbles on it, and one of them actually teased the return of Taco. In season 3, the Calm Down Corner is replaced by the Calm Down Cabana, where it serves as a confessional booth for the contestants. Alternate Dimension. In season 2, episode 12, Lightbulb and Test Tube accidentally return to the past, and after Lightbulb messed around a bit, she caused Salt and Pepper to win the first challenge instead of herself and Balloon, somehow affecting the timeline so much that Salt and Pepper end up winning the first season. They end up using the prize money to host a new season called Inanimate Insanity Infinity, where they are the hosts, featuring completely new contestants, and the grass to turn purple for some reason. Oh yeah, Pepper also kills Salt, by the way, I forgot to mention that. Nickle. Back in season 1, voting was held in the comment section, which was unfortunate for one contestant called Nickel, because viewers would often misspell his name, and the most popular misname was Nickle. It even got to the point where Lightbulb was eliminated instead of Nickel because of how many people misspelled his name. The Inanimate Insanity team had enough of this, and so to make sure no one misspells Nickel again, they made fun of the misspellers by creating a character called Nickle to mock them.
I'm highly offended!
Judging from his appearance, he might be Mifon's bodyguard or something, but sadly, he's been mostly forgotten. ADAM. Following off from the Adam entry earlier, Adam Katz also has an in-universe representation called ADAM. He serves as the in-universe producer of Inanimate Insanity, and he also has some fire choice in art, if I do say so myself. In recent episodes, Adam was revealed to just be another robot created by Meeple, so Steve Jobs could stay in control over Inanimate Insanity. Evil Paper. In season 1, Paper had this alternate personality called Evil Paper that was caused from the trauma he received being trapped in Idiotic Island. Anytime somebody said the word Idiotic Island, Evil Paper would come out.
Idiotic Island, what? It's fun!
Paper defeated Evil Paper by throwing a piano on him inside his subconscious. Account hacked. In 2011, the Animation Epic account was hacked and all of the episodes released at the time were deleted. The hacker was actually the voice actor of Balloon at the time, and so they fired him. And the rest of season 1 just reused lines.
Oh, come on!
In season 2, they actually rehired him for 6 episodes, before he was replaced with Ben Cross, who is the current voice actor of Balloon. The BFDI and II meetup. The BFDI and II meetup was a convention that took place in Los Angeles. The convention happened twice, in 2019 and 2020. The convention let you connect with other Object Show fans, buy BFDI and Animate Insanity merchandise, and a Q&A with the creators of BFDI and Animate Insanity. Humans. Unlike how BFDI actively avoids mentioning humans, Inanimate Insanity embraces humans, and there are a lot of human characters, like the before mentioned Nikle and Santa Claus. Spoiled Lemon. Spoiled Lemon is a famous band in the Inanimate Insanity world. The band is composed of guava, tomato, pineapple, lemon, starfruit, and mangosteen. And it's also how Miphone tricked the contestants to compete in season 3, by giving them fake Spoiled Lemon tickets. Life Ring. Okay, I know you know who Life Ring is, but did you know Life Ring actually makes an appearance much earlier in episode 3 of season 2, where he works as the lifeguard for the pool?
That's my job!
The recap. Every season 1 episode had a recap of the last episode in the first couple minutes.
Last time on Inanimate Insanity.
We know that the recap is alive, because Miphone literally pushed it off a cliff. The next episode revealed that the recap actually tried to file a lawsuit against Miphone.
Long story short, pressing charges.
In season 2 episode 13, Fenn tried making his own recap. And it's funny, because the voice actor of the recap is actually the same voice actor as Fenn, both being voiced by Brian Koch. OSC Connected Universe. In various Inanimate Insanity episodes, we can see several BFDI characters interact with the cast, like Pencil, Coiny, Fiery, Cloudy, Puffball Speakerbox, and Non-Existy. Inanimate Insanity also features a lot of characters from other shows, like Window from Object Universe, Gamey from Object Overload, PKX from Object Madness, and Dor from the Object Show movie. Milk. Milk is a very strange character. Her only appearance was in Everything's AOJ, where she spectates Miphone for trial and does absolutely nothing. My theory is that she might be related to OJ, and was also possibly a resident of Hotel OJ, because Miphone's crime was committed inside the hotel. The stupid trailer. Before Inanimate Insanity, and even before the Animation Epic channel, Adam Katz uploaded a trailer for Inanimate Insanity on his personal YouTube channel. The trailer was titled The Stupid Trailer, and is probably the oldest Inanimate Insanity animation ever. Some of the highlights of the trailer are Taco singing about forgetting her own name.
You tell me, because I forgot.
She forgot.
And the incredibly cursed armless pickle. Truly a sight to behold. Advertisements. This video is sponsored by Raid Shadow Legends. Okay, no, I'm just kidding. This entry is referring to how, like BFDI, Inanimate Insanity also has fake advertising. Like the rubber ball ad.
It's a ball. He's got a rubber ball. It's a ball.
Both Jared.
It's a chair.
And also for some reason, an advertisement made by Cheesy for a Minecraft server called CheesyCraft.
Hi, I own CheesyCraft, a Minecraft server.
And this ad was apparently so bad, it made Cheesy choose a completely different career path, where he became a comedian. Embarrassing image. In season 3, episode 3, two camera characters come up to Miphone 4, and show him they made an article exposing him. In the article was an embarrassing photo of Miphone 4. You can barely make out that it's actually a screen cap from the first couple frames of the first episode. Live audience reaction. Inanimate Insanity season 2 episode 3 was broadcasted on the 2014 National Film Festival for Talented Youth, in front of an audience of 300 people. But the only thing that made the audience laugh were the funny faces, which is kinda sad. Inanimate Insanity was an official parody of Inanimate Insanity that featured terribly drawn art and extremely pitched down voices.
Bow, smell my sandwich.
It was made as a prank for people expecting Inanimate Insanity 12, only to be met with this. This was the last entry for Meeple Skies. Let's move down a layer. T-shirt contest. In 2012, the Inanimate Insanity team held a contest. If you sent in a video of you wearing an Inanimate Insanity t-shirt, you get the chance for your character to appear in the show. The four winners recommended Banana, Rubber Ball, Guitar, and Yin Yang. And I think we all know who the winner was. Alternate season 3 thumbnail. The season 3 episode 1 thumbnail looks like this, but over on Adam's Twitter, the thumbnail is a little bit different, where it has a regular morning sky instead of sunset. Media references. Inanimate Insanity has multiple references to shows and video games. For example, episode 4 has cameos from the Angry Bird characters Red and Chuck, and episode 11 has SpongeBob's Pineapple House. Test Tube Tango. When the trailer for season 2 episode 14 was released, everyone expected this scene with Test Tube and fireworks to be a song. The fans dubbed the song Test Tube Tango. And then, the episode was released, and there was no song. But because so many fans wanted to hear what it could have been like, the Inanimate Insanity team actually composed Test Tube Tango. And it's just phenomenal.
Thank you.
Yin Yang is incorrect. According to Chinese philosophy, the dark side of a Yin Yang is called Yin, and the white side is the Yang. This is switched in Animate Insanity, where the white side is called Yin, and the black side is called Yang. Nickel Steps on Conserving Water. This was another video that was deleted due to the account being hacked. It had Nickel teaching Knife the importance of recycling, because Knife was throwing his water bottles into this pixely toilet PNG. They end up using the water bottle to water flower from BFDI. I'm gonna group all of these entries together, because they all come from one video. A video called Inanimate Insanity Secrets. In the finale of Inanimate Insanity, Pepper was supposed to die instead of Bo. This was later replaced. Balloon and Cheesy weren't originally planned to be in season 2, but after they decided Balloon would develop a new personality and Cheesy would become a jokester, they were included. Bo's original color was yellow. In season 3, episode 10, where they introduced the immunity cookie that turned you into gold, I immediately made a community tab post, saying how cool it would be for Bo to get the cookie so she could look more like her original design. And then the next episode, guess what happened? Some characters had unused assets. Microphone, in the corner of episode 18, had a completely different asset. Trophy was supposed to have a wooden base. Soap was originally a bar of soap. And Test Tube was originally supposed to be a pair of goggles. Balloon was going to become female, but it was scrapped. One gender change that wasn't scrapped was Lightbulb. She was male in early episodes, and then became female from episode 3 onwards. It's up to your interpretation whether you think she's transgender, but I personally think she is. 8 characters were dropped from season 2. The 8 of them are Chip. Chip was originally supposed to be a needle knockoff, because he would hate being called Fry. Hot Sauce. Hot Sauce was inspired from Baguette from Brawl of the Objects. In Brawl of the Objects, Baguette could only speak French. In Inanimate Insanity, Hot Sauce could only speak Spanish. Game Boy Color. Game Boy Color was an old-timer grandpa who was always confused. Pearl. Pearl was an annoying spoiled brat that wanted to be treated like royalty. Textbook. Textbook was a nerdy loner character that no one cared about. Haybale was western and proud, but slightly dumb. And finally, Frank was just a cool guy stereotype. These last two eventually evolved into two contestants from Inanimate Insanity Infinity, Frank and Haybale. This was a shorter layer. Now, let's move down to the glacier itself. Cut season 1, episode 18. This scene was cut because Derek couldn't finish his lines as Pickle. Take a watch.
What do you want?
Clearly, you do not stay up to date with Meeple News. If you did, you would know that me Form 4S, was just announced.
So?
So? I'm Better Technology. I have the new M5 chip.
Oh, I have sour cream and onion. Trade?
Not that kind of chip, you f***.
Gemory's origin. The gems from the memory cave from season 2, episode 13, are actually based off of this emoji. It was originally supposed to represent a blue flower, but over time, it evolved into this weird meaningless gem thing. Inanimate battle contestants. The previously mentioned Inanimate Battle had some new contestants other than existing contestants. For example, Big Orange Spoon, Twinkie, and Matza. Fixed episodes. Some of the season 1 Inanimate Insanity videos have broken audio, so they sound like this.
I can't go in there! I'll get soggy!
If you're planning on re-watching season 1, every broken video has a link to a fixed version in the description. Tired of the Inanimate Insanity hiatus? Tired of the Inanimate Insanity hiatus is a 2-video series created by Brian Koch, made while Inanimate Insanity went on hiatus for the summer. This video was the first ever appearance of Fun. For some reason, the video is now deleted, and for the life of me, I can't find the original. The only re-upload I was able to find has this red filter and extremely bass-boosted audio, so we're gonna suffer through this together.
And we're going on a hiatus for the summer.
Trust me, I tried contacting Brian. It didn't work. The first episode shows Fun buzzering Miphon 4 on his break to host a new episode of Inanimate Insanity. And so he makes a season with puppets. The second video features all of the contestants sleeping and Miphon ignoring his alarm clock. Young Arts. Adam Katz made an ad for the Young Arts charity, featuring a lot of new characters like Tutu, Camera, Trumpet, Mask, and Clapboard. Oh, and microphone sounds like this.
My angelic voice is winning this.
Tyler Bangard. Tyler Bangard is the riddle monster that lives in the desert. The only reason I put him this low on the iceberg is because what you might not know is that he's named after a fan of Inanimate Insanity called Tyler Bangard. Taco Scar. This entry is a bit of a mixed bag, because some people might think it's really obvious, and some, like me, didn't even realize it. But the reason Taco has this scar on her face in episode 14 is because a memory gem was dropped on her face in the last episode. Candle's beta design. In the concept art of season 3, Candle was designed to be in a jar. This was dropped for the Candle design we know today. The Taco Show. When the Animation Epic channel was hacked, this series was also deleted. a game show hosted by Taco. The first episode featured an interview with OJ, where Taco changed his liquid into Kool-Aid, and then threatened him with strange yellow liquid.
What liquid is it?
I don't know, we found it on the street.
This show was weird. Clip art asset. We all know early in Animate Insanity episodes were really lazy. So lazy, in fact, they didn't even bother to make an original asset for paper. His asset is literally just an image from Google. Forky cameo. In Miphon 4's glitchy object mess, you can find Forky from Toy Story 4 in the exact same plastic box he was found in the movie, which is a really cool reference. Cabbage and Pasta. Like an Animate Battle, Animate Insanity also has two new characters, being Cabbage and Pasta. And there's not much more to say. Box's secret message. In season 2, episode 1, Lightbulb tried to talk to Box. And if you listen really closely, you can see that Box actually speaks back, but in reverse. If you reverse the clip, he actually says a swear word. You can reverse it yourself if you want. But basically, he says, "You reversed the clip, didn't you?" Ballpoint Pen's beta design. In the storyboard phase, Ballpoint Pen from season 3 had a more curvy design, glasses, and a scarf. All of these attributes were dropped, probably just for the joke of his silhouette looking like Steve Cobbs. Cut season 2 episode 3 scene. It was actually cut for being way too violent. The scene depicted Young splitting apple in half by the center of the apple. Cutting an apple by the center in real life is actually really difficult, and can very much injure your fingers. Oh wait, never mind, Joe Bartolozzi did it.
Apple?
Oh, cue the spooky music because we're getting into the final layer. Oatmeal Raisin PSA. The Oatmeal Raisin PSA was a video created by Brian that was supposed to appear at the end of season 2, episode 2, but it was removed because of glitches.
Oatmeal Raisin Cookies, just a harmless little dessert treat, right? Wrong! These tiny monstrosities have caused the pandemic known to the public as global warming. Don't believe it. The once majestic Gladstonian glacier featured just last month on Inanimate Insanity is now melting, all thanks to oatmeal raisin.
Luckily, the Gladstonian glacier doesn't seem to be melting, as we saw it in season 3, episode 13. Cheesy plush. In a video showcasing the updates to the Inanimate Insanity website, sitting behind Brian and Adam is a plush of Cheesy. It's obviously not up to the standard of current Inanimate Insanity plushes, and it seems to be very homemade. But I'm just wondering, out of all the contestants they could have made a plush of, why Cheesy? The Coin Bros. The Coin Bros was a school project made by Adam Katz and Brian Koch about the Korean Memorial. And this was actually Adam's first ever animation. Purple Balloon. Purple Balloon was a character on the Animation Epic Twitter that was used to advertise the Animation Epic Instagram. But what you might not realize is that they have actually been a part of Inanimate Insanity this whole time, and you just haven't noticed them. Okay, no, I'm kidding.
No, you're fake.
Bo's Twitter takeover. In Halloween of 2017, Bo took over the Animation Epic Twitter account and started tweeting from her perspective in the Purgatory Mansion. Bo also somehow got access to storyboard footage of the next episode, and teased some scenes of season 2, episode 11. Yarn. During the song of episode 12 in the alternate timeline, we can see Kumquat, Lightbulb, Barrel, and Traffic Light playing a Monopoly ripoff. And one of them is playing as a never-before-seen Yarn character, which is probably a contestant of Inanimate Insanity Infinity that was eliminated prior, Purgatory Mansion. The Purgatory Mansion is the place where dead Inanimate Insanity ghosts live. The definition of Purgatory is a place where you go after death to be purified or temporarily punished. Maybe this is a sign that Bo and Doe are sent to the Purgatory Mansion so they could fix their flaws and mistakes before being sent to heaven. Bowinator. In season 2, among Test Tube's inventions, we can find the Bowinator, which we can assume is the early, unfinished version of Bot. A reminder, this was 9 years ago. The fact they kept this for so long is really cool. Adam Katz is Barack Obama, the 44th president of the United States of America. Okay, cut the spooky music, I can't take this one seriously. Basically, what this entry is referring to is how for the longest time, if you search Adam Katz on Google Images, the image that would show up is actually of Barack Obama. And I actually managed to find why. The top Google result was a GIF of Adam Katz morphing into Barack Obama. And for some reason, Google just cut out the first frame and put it as his picture. Grand Pairs. This is probably the weirdest entry on this iceberg. For the 6-year anniversary special of Inanimate Insanity, instead of doing a merch drop or an event like recent years, Animation Epic gave us this. With the tweet saying, "In honor of our 6th anniversary, the Grand Slams are getting a new member and are officially becoming the Grand Pairs. Happy 6 years." I have no idea what this tweet means, and I really hope we never see this character again. Test Tubes Liquid. A series suggests that Test... That's hard to say. Test tubes liquid is a liquid called ethylene glycol, also known as antifreeze, which is a liquid used in cars for cooling systems. If you were to drink antifreeze, the effects are similar to that of being drunk. Similar to what we see in season 2 episode 11, where test tubes act drunk when she doesn't have her liquid. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to like and subscribe. See you next time.